Friends, after a long time, I could not upload the video on the current affairs of June 2018. And since the exam is approaching, so I have quickly selected the current affairs for the June 2018. And this current affair is especially selected for the upcoming exam, phase 1. Mahesh Kumar Jain appointed as RBI Deputy Governor. The government has appointed IDBI Bank Chief Executive Officer Mahesh Kumar Jain as a Deputy Governor of the Reserve Bank of India for a period of 3 years. He will fill the post vacated by S.S. Mundra, who had completed his 3-year term in July last year. SBI's B. Sriram has been appointed CMD of IDBI Bank. He will take the position of Sri M.K. Jain. Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India approved a proposal allowing Life Insurance Corporation to acquire a majority stake in the IDBI Bank. Under the proposal, LIC can raise its stake in the public sector bank to 51%, injecting ₹10,000 to 30,000 crore in the debt-ridden lender IDBI Bank. India signs agreement with the World Bank for Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana. The government of India and the World Bank signed a $500 million loan agreement to provide additional financing for the Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana. Roads in the rural areas are developed under this project. Singapore names exotic orchid after PM Narendra Modi. An orchid has been named after Prime Minister Narendra Modi to commemorate his visit to the National Orchid Garden of Singapore. It is named Dendrobium Narendra Modi to mark Prime Minister's visit. It is the only tropical garden to be listed as a UNESCO World Heritage Site. PM Narendra Modi unveils plaque at Singapore's Clipboard Pier paying tribute to Mahatma Gandhi. Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Singapore's former Premier Goh Chok Tong jointly unveiled a plaque to pay tribute to Mahatma Gandhi at the immersion site of his ashes at the waterfront Clipboard Pier. It should be noted that after Mahatma Gandhi's death, his ashes were sent to various parts of India and the world, including Singapore and for immersion. Amitabh Bachchan to be face of Railway's anti-trespassing campaign. Actor Amitabh Bachchan has become the face of Central Railway's anti-trespassing campaign. Trespassing on railway tracks is a major cause of death on Mumbai Suburban Rail Network. Central Railway has launched an initiative, Ek Safar Rail Ke Saath, where celebrities will share their experience about Indian Railways and their journey in a short film. Kailas Satyarthi receives Santokh Ba Humanitarian Award. Nobel laureate Shri Kailas Satyarthi was honored with Santokh Kuba Humanitarian Award by President Ramnath Kovind for his services aimed at the betterment of society. Former ISRO President Shri A.S. Kiran Kumar also received the award. Shri Satyarthi received Nobel Peace Prize in 2014 for Save the Childhood Movement, which he started in 1980. The award is given every year by Shri Ramakrishna Foundation to people who have worked extensively for the betterment of society. RBI revised the upward housing loan limits under priority sector lending. Housing loans of up to Rs 35 lakh for residences costing less than Rs 45 lakh will now be treated as priority sector lending to give a boost to the low cost segment. The Housing loan limits for eligibility under priority sector lending will be revised to Rs 35 lakh in metropolitan centers and to Rs 25 lakh in other centers. India's first advanced forensic lab in Chandigarh. Srimati Meneka Gandhi, Minister for Women and Child Development, laid foundation of Sakhi Suraksha Advanced DNA Forensic Laboratory in the campus of Central Forensic Science Lab, Chandigarh. Forensic lab will play a critical role in criminal investigation and will contribute to address the gap in forensic DNA analysis of pending sexual assault cases in the country. The lab is being set up as a model forensic lab and would be replicated in other parts of the country. Indian Institute of Sciences, Bengaluru make it to world top university list. Bengaluru's Indian Institute of Sciences has made it to list of top 100 in the World Reputation Ranking 2018. It has been ranked at 91 and is the only Indian university to have made it to the prestigious list. Harvard University topped the list. Andhra government to give allowance to the unemployed youth. Andhra Pradesh government has announced to give a monthly allowance of Rs 1,000 to unemployed graduate youth. The entire scheme has a budget outlay of Rs 1200 crores. There is no restriction on the number per family. The upper age is 35 years. India ranked at 137th on Global Peace Index 2018. India has moved up 4 places to the 137th rank among 163 countries on the 2018 Global Peace Index. Iceland remains the most peaceful country in the world, a position it has held since 2008. Syria remains the least peaceful country in the world, a position it has held for the last 5 years. G7 Summit 2018 held in Canada. The 44th G7 Summit was held on June 8-9, 2018 in Canada. The summit received significant attention due to a significant decline of relations of members with the United States. Due to this, the summit was dubbed the G6 plus 1 by France and some members of the media. Earlier, it was known as G8, but in March 2014, Russia was removed and it became G7. The G7 is a group consisting of Canada, France, Germany, Italy, Japan, the United Kingdom, and the US. India's first indigenous artillery gun, Dhanush. India's first indigenous long-range artillery gun, Dhanush, has passed its final test at Pokhran in Rajasthan. Dhanush is a 155mm by 45mm calibre artillery gun and is also called the Desi Bofors. It has a strike range of 38 km and 81% of its components are indigenously sourced. Japanese passport ranked most powerful in the world. Henry and Partners Annual Passport Index gives this ranking. This ranks passport based on the number of countries a holder can go to without a visa or the number of countries a holder can go to where they can obtain a visa. Japan has been deemed the world's most powerful passport with access to 189 countries. Singapore and Germany have secured the second place with 188 countries. India has bagged the 76th position, where Indian passport allows to 56 countries. Arvind Saxena appointed as acting UPSC chief. UPSC member Arvind Saxena has been appointed as the acting chairman of the commission from June 20, a government order said. Saxena, a 1978 batch Indian Postal Service officer, will take over the charge from incumbent Vinay Mittal, who completes his term at the Union Public Service Commission on June 19. Sharad Kumar appointed as Vigilance Commissioner. Shri Sharad Kumar has been appointed as the Vigilance Commissioner in the Central Vigilance Commission, New Delhi. His appointment will be for a term of 4 years from the date on which he enters upon his office or till he attains the age of 65 years, whichever is earlier. Sebastian Vettel wins Canadian Grand Prix. Ferrari's Sebastian Vettel dominated the Canadian Grand Prix. Mercedes' Valtteri Bottas finished second. Red Bull's Max Verstappen took third after a valiant but unsuccessful attempt to pass Bottas. National Tribal Museum proposed to be set up at Delhi. A National Tribal Museum, along with a national level tribal research institute, is proposed to be set up at Delhi by the Ministry of Tribal Affairs. The museum will showcase the rich tribal culture and heritage using state-of-the-art technologies. As per the announcement made by the Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi in his Independence Day speech on 15th August 2016, Ministry of Tribal Affairs is setting up 6 tribal freedom fighters memorials, including 2 of national importance, that is Narmada in Gujarat and Birsa Munda Central Jail in Ranchi. Indian-American Divya Suryadevara becomes CFO of General Motors. An Indian-American woman, Divya Suryadevara, has been named the Chief Finance Officer of the US largest automaker, General Motors. Roger Federer wins Mercedes Cup. Roger Federer beat Milos Raonic to win the Mercedes Cup in Stuttgart, his event for 2.5 months. Federer 36 beat Canadian Raonic in the final. Oriental Bank of Commerce awarded for Atal Pension Yojana. Oriental Bank of Commerce has been awarded as the best public sector bank for Atal Pension Yojana for the year 2017-18. Mehbooba Mukti resigns as J&K Chief Minister. Jammu and Kashmir Chief Minister Mehbooba Mukti has sent her resignation to Governor N.N. Vora after the BJP decided to leave the alliance with PDP. The state of Jammu and Kashmir has come under Governor's rule with immediate effect. Governor N.N. Vora will now be running the state for a 4th time since his appointment in 2008. Arvind Subramaniam resigns as CEA of India. Chief Economic Advisor Arvind Subramaniam has submitted his resignation. Shri Subramaniam started his term as CEA on October 16, 2014 for a term of 3 years. On the completion of 3 years, he was asked to continue for a year more, which was till October 2018. US leaves the UN Human Rights Council. US Ambassador to the United Nations Nikki Haley and US Secretary of State Mike Pompeo have announced the US was withdrawing from the UN Human Rights Council. In doing so, they claimed the council was a roadblock to genuine global human rights protection. Anukriti Vas from Tamil Nadu crowned Femina Miss India 2018. Anukriti Vas, a 19-year-old Tamil Nadu college student, has been crowned Femina Miss India 2018 in a grand ceremony in Mumbai. Anukriti Vas, who was previously crowned APB Colors Femina Miss Tamil Nadu, beat 30 contestants to bag the top honor. PM Modi inaugurates Nature Center in New York via video link. On the occasion of the 4th International Day of Yoga, Prime Minister Narendra Modi inaugurated a nature center named YO1, also known as YO1, whose Hindi meaning is youth. Nature Cure Center in the Catskills area of New York through a video link. Yovan is established by SL Group of Dr. Subhash Chandra, who also owns Z Media Group. International Indian Film Academy Award 2018 took place in Bangkok. The winners under different categories are as here under: Best Film, Tumhari Sulu; Best Actor in a Leading Role, Female, Sridevi; Best Actor in a Leading Role, Male, Irfan Khan for Hindi Medium; Best Director, Saket Chaudhary, Hindi Medium. Pakistan is placed on FATF's grey list. Pakistan has been placed on the grey list of countries that financially aid terrorism in Paris by the Financial Action Task Force. This listing could hurt Pakistan's economy as well as its international standing. The FATF is an intergovernmental body established in 1989 to combat money laundering, terrorist financing, and other related threats to the integrity of the international financial system. Center to replace UGC with HECI. The center is set up to abolish UGC and form a new Higher Education Commission of India by repealing the UGC Act 1951. The proposed Higher Education Commission of India would focus solely on academic matters, and monetary grants would be under the purview of the ministry. North Korea has been named worst human trafficking country. The US state government has categorized North Korea as one of the worst human trafficking nation for the 16th straight year, citing the use of forced labor. A committee constituted to celebrate 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. A national committee under the chairmanship of the President of India has been constituted for this purpose. The first meeting of the national committee was held on 2 May 2018 in New Delhi. An executive committee under the chairmanship of Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi has been constituted, comprising of senior ministers in cabinet, leader of opposition, renowned Gandhians, social activists, and noted public figures. NTPC Limited has adopted Charminar under Swachh Iconic Places project. NTPC Limited has adopted the iconic Charminar in Hyderabad under the Swachh Iconic Places project of India. Dalmia Bharat Limited had adopted Red Fort Delhi and Gandhi Kota Fort in Andhra Pradesh under the scheme. Asia's first blue flag beaches to be developed in India. 13 Indian beaches will soon get the blue flag certification. To get blue flag standards, a beach has to strictly comply with 33 environment and tourism related conditions. These beaches of Maharashtra, Odisha, and other coastal states will be the first in not just India but in Asia to get the blue flag certification. World Bank has approved Rs 6000 crore Atal Bhujal Yojana. The World Bank has approved Atal Bhujal Yojana, a Rs 6000 crore center sector scheme of the Ministry of Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation. The scheme is to be implemented over a period of 5 years from 2018-19 to 2022-23 with World Bank assistance. USA, Canada and Mexico to host 2026 FIFA World Cup. FIFA members voted to award the right to host the 2026 tournament to a joint bid from United States, Canada and Mexico. The 2022 FIFA World Cup is scheduled to take place in Qatar. International Day of Yoga, 21st June. International Day of Yoga, or commonly known and unofficially referred to as Yoga Day, has been celebrated annually on 21st June since its inception in 2015. It was held in Dehradun in India. The theme for the Yoga Day 2018 is Yoga for Peace. India to construct war memorial in France. India will construct a war memorial at Villers-Guislain, a town around 200 kilometers from Paris, to honor the valor and sacrifice of the thousands of its soldiers, sailors, and airmen who fought for peace in the World War I? India and Seychelles agree on naval base at Assumption Island. India and Seychelles has agreed to work together on a project to develop a naval base at the Assumption Island. Saudi Arabia issues first driving license to women. Saudi Arabia has issued driving license to women for the first time in decades just before a ban on female drivers is lifted. 10 women swapped their foreign license for Saudi ones in cities across the country. A flood of applications is now expected in the run-up to 24 June when the ban will end. India's R. Pragnadhana becomes world's second youngest chess grandmaster. In a historic event, Chennai-based R. Pragnadhana has become India's youngest and second youngest grandmaster in the world at 12 years, 10 months and 13 days. Pragnanda became India's youngest grandmaster after making it to the final round at the Gridiron Open in Italy to clinch his third grandmaster. Srikanth wins Sportsperson of the Year 2018. Indian shuttler Kidambi Srikanth has been adjudged as the Sportsperson of the Year for 2018 by the Sports Illustrated Indian magazine. Vasundhara Raje conferred with Chief Minister of the Year Award. Rajasthan Chief Minister Vasundhara Raje was conferred the Chief Minister of the Year Award for her remarkable work in e-governance. Friends, this was the current affairs for the June 2018 month, and I have already made the videos on the current affairs for March, April and May also, and I am placing the link in the description box for these March, April and May videos. And I'll suggest you to go through all the videos for the current affairs, and these videos have been specifically selected for the banking exams and especially for Reserve Bank of India exam. And please keep watching these videos. You can watch these videos while doing other activities, like when you are driving, when you are going somewhere, you can watch these videos using headphones. And I'm going to place many more videos for the phase 2 exams. So keep watching. If you like my video, please don't forget to comment. It gives me motivation to make more videos. And please like. Thank you so much.